Hello everybody, and once again welcome back to another episode of 135th Scale Figures in Review. As always, I'd like to thank everybody who has subscribed to my channel, also those people that have viewed my channel and seen the different things that all go with 135th Scale Figures. And what I'm hoping to do, and the whole purpose of my channel, is to show everybody that what average Joe modelers like me can do with our figure sets that are available to us in 135th scale. Today, what we're going to look at is two figures from the Alpine range, and these are the two Kharkov figures that Taesoon Harms has produced. And as always, they're excellent figures to look at. Okay, the first one is going to be a Waffen SS NCO in the Kharkov Anorak Parka is what they have. And the other one is going to be the Grenadier. Okay, now these are both resin figures done by Alpine. And as always, Alpine speaks for itself. They're going to be excellent figures. So without hesitation, let's get that ball rolling in this figure review. Okay, we're going to go ahead and get started with the out-of-the-box portion of the review. And here are your two figures for the Alpine. Now you can buy these together in one box. And as always, I've got my purchase for these Alpine figures from lastcavalry.com. Dave Youngquist over there has always been very gracious for me in being able to get these figures to me. Okay, here they are. The NCO, Waffen, and these are both Waffen SS figures in the Kharkov Anoraks. They're parkas that they wear during this time, 1943, the winter of. And the other fella is the Waffen SS Grenadier. Now, these two figures will be also with a third figure for a vignette I have planned to put on a base that I'm getting from Dave Youngquist. And hopefully that'll also be a type of review or a video how-to when I put that vignette together. Okay, so let's go ahead and go with out-of-the-box portion of this review, and we'll start with the NCO. Okay, and as always, you're looking at the box from Alpine. Okay, outstanding artwork done on the front. Okay, and this has been done by Jamie Ortiz. Okay, on the side you see the clear packaging, and here you go, the instructions, and the website for Alpine is on the back, alpineminiatures.com. All right, and as always, these are just all the same on how they're packaged, which is obviously outstanding how they're put together. And here is our first figure. And by the way, I'm giving another shot at a new app on my phone to be able to do these and do these right. That'll allow maybe some zooms. Okay, here you have the packaging, and the one figure will come into one pack. And we'll go ahead and open this guy up here. And we'll go ahead and put him out, and we'll get started on the review. Okay. Okay, first things first, we're going to go ahead and look at the MP40 machine gun that they have. Okay, and I'm going to go ahead and get the focus in a little bit on this guy. Okay, and here it is. Okay, once again, you see the carrier that they go ahead and they'll use with all their figures, and you'll see the hands are already placed on the machine gun themselves, the machine pistol. Okay, and with the resin carrier of Alpine, once again, you have very, very slight attachment points. These would be very easily removed. This is the stock for the MP40, and this is also a separate piece. And this guy also is carrying his pistol, okay, and his holster right here. Okay, that's what you're seeing there. All right, these are the two heads that you're going to get from Alpine, and as always, Alpine gives you two choices of heads. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and zoom in a little bit tighter on this and see if we can get a better look at these guys here, and we'll go ahead and do our focus, and there they are. Okay, outstanding figures. Okay, outstanding heads. And once again, you see the carrier is very minimal. This gentleman has his steel helmet on this one right here. Okay, the strap, nice facial features for him. Okay, and this gentleman has the cap. Okay, he also has some of his hair coming out the side of the cap. Okay, he's got it over the top of his ears because this is in the winter of 1943. Okay, one of the last great victories for the Germans and Russia at that time. And then once again, here's the carrier film, and this is obviously always easily removed. Okay, and then we'll go ahead and take a peek at this guy in his anorak. All right, and I'll go ahead and do a little bit better job of focusing on this right here. I do like my new app. All right, and you see he's got his machine pistol ammunition right here. He's got some binoculars that he has right here. You see his hands are the sleeves are hollowed out to go ahead and take the hands. And what I'll do, as I've been doing lately with most of my figures I've reviewed, I'll pin these so they're easily to move in and out. Okay, you see the collars that he has right here, and you'll be able to even put the SS emblem right here. Okay, and as we kind of do a quick little walk around, you see the nice detail of the straps right here. Let me go ahead and see if I can get our exposure just a little bit different. Okay, on this, but now we're going to be good here. All right, you see the nice folds, and this is characteristic of all Alpine figures. Very nicely done. The clothing just lays naturally across the figure's body. You see his belt. Okay, right here, you see the hood of the anorak. Okay, you see the fur that's inside the hood itself right here. Okay, once again, very, very good detail in this figure. Okay, as we continue the turn, once again, you're seeing the folds. I'll come up here and you'll see the winter boots that he has. Okay, very minimal attachment points. Okay, that are right here. Okay, nice folds, nice draping of his clothing. Okay, once again, all in all, this is just a typical well-cast Alpine. Very, very minimal cleanup, if any. Okay, once again, it doesn't ever hurt to go into a resin figure and go over them before you prime them up to make sure that things are cleaned up pretty good. Okay, all right, that's that, the NCO out of the box. Okay, let's go ahead and we'll back out our zoom so it's not quite as intense. Okay, we'll come back here. And now this is the Grenadier, okay, out of the box. So we'll go ahead and open him up. Okay, he's going to come out in his one package right here, and here they are. Okay, once again, nothing, no surprises coming from Alpine. Okay, let's go ahead and open this guy up, and we'll go ahead and do a quick review on him. Lay out the figure, box, and here we go. Okay, now first thing I'll go ahead and show you is his K98 rifle. All right, let's go ahead and we'll do a little bit of zoom action in here. Okay, all right, once again, very minimal attachment points, great detail on the rifle. Okay, very easy cleanup for this. All right, we'll put this off to the side over here. And then with this gentleman, okay, he's got his canteen, is right here, and now he has a separate arm as opposed to the other figure that did the two, and you'll see the folds are also nicely done in this arm. Okay, you see the hand down in the sleeve, it's nice and recessed there. You see the nice folds right here, good clean area that you're gonna have, and once again, as always, very minimal attachment to the resin carrier. Okay, let's go ahead and take these two heads. I'll put them side by side if I can do that right now. Okay, we'll get a little bit of a zoom on this. We'll focus up a little bit clearer. And here we are. Okay, once again, you have a choice of a steel helmet for the one gentleman right here. Okay, good strap detail. Okay, good attachment point for the resin carrier. And then you have this one. Now, this gentleman doesn't have the cap. He's got the side cap, and he's got a lot of hair showing on this guy. Okay, which is fine. It's going to be able to one of those, a little bit of a painting challenge, a little bit different for some people, but if you take your time with it, it won't be much of an issue. Great facial detail and minimal carrier right here, okay? And then we'll go ahead and look at the main body of this guy right here also. Okay, and here we are as the same. This is the Kharkov anorak, or the winter parka that they'll have. Great belt detail. Now he has the K98 rifle. All right, great strap detail, as you can see right here. Okay, good folds coming over. Now this gentleman's gonna have a scarf, okay, right here in his that he'll be wearing underneath his anorak. Good fold coming across. Nice lay of the clothing. You see this arm's coming down naturally. Okay, this hand's right here with a nice recess action right there. Okay, we'll go ahead and just do a turn. Okay, there's the hood. Now this guy has his rifle, and this is the rifle strap that you'll see coming across. All right, great detail. Here's the bread bag. Okay, this is attachment point for his canteen. Okay, good fold. Once again, they lay very naturally. Okay, on the body. Here's the attachment points for the boots. Very minimal attachment point. The cleanup on these guys is going to be real quick. Here's just a little bit of flash, and you can actually even take your finger and scrape that off. Okay, well done again by Alpine. Like I said before, this is going to be these are two figures of a three-figure little vignette I'm going to be putting together, and like I say, I'll hopefully do a how-to on that one. So that ends the portion of the out-of-the-box review for these great figures, and we'll go ahead and stop here with this, and I'll show you the figures when they're all put together. Okay, here is our completed figure portion of the video review, and these are the two Alpine figures for the Kharkov scenario. You have the NCO on this side right here, and this is the Grenadier. And as typical with Alpine figures, they went together very, very well. Very quick cleanup. The engineering of where the pieces go and how they come together is outstanding. And we'll go ahead and take a real good look at the NCO with his MP40. We'll bring him up here a little closer, and we'll see if I can get my focus to work, and it seems to be working pretty good right there. So here you go, look at this guy. Okay, now I've done something a little bit different besides pinning them. Okay, I used what they call blue tack, and blue tack is a sticky gummy adhesive that is a temporary adhesive. It does not leave any residue, and it allows the figures or whatever bits and pieces you have to stay in position fairly solidly until it's time to move on and paint. And then when you take the blue tack off, there's no residue. You can paint them up and there's no issues. And now I'm going to do a review segment in my 1/35 scale figures in review videos dealing with the different types of adhesives and things like this. But here we go with this guy right here. Let me see if I can get him focused in just a little bit better. Okay, all right. Now I chose to put the helmet on this guy, the helmeted head, and it fits nice and snug right in here. Okay, we'll go ahead and bring the focus back out a little bit here. Okay, and as you see him, here you go. You look at the folds, his hands. I did pin this. This hand with on the MP40, okay, but then I put some blue tack in this grip. Okay, this the stock glued very easily, very nicely on the MP40. You just have to be careful trimming it off, and here he is. Okay, we'll do our slow turn, and of course with all my videos you'll have some still pictures afterwards. Okay, here is his pistol attached to the back of his belt. Okay, the back of the head, the flay of the arms, all right, the arms were already in position, so you just need to position the hands. Okay, so like I said, this will paint up very, very well. And this is, of course, the Kharkov anorak outfit that he's wearing. Okay, you see the detail back here, the different folds that they have with their coat, how everything lays naturally here. Okay, and so this guy came together. Like I say, I cleaned these things up and put them together in maybe 30 minutes. All right, and now we'll come to the NCO. And this is a really nice feature with this guy right here. Okay, with him, okay, and I'll come around to the back end of him here in just a minute. He has the K98 rifle, the German Wehrmacht. Okay, here is the folds that he has. Here's his ammunition sit there. Now I chose just as the two different heads, I chose instead of the steel helmet, I decided to put the side cap on this guy. And once again, I can, because he's just blue tacked in there, I can change heads out if I choose to do that. Okay, as we come around, and this is what I mean about the engineering with this, In this part right here, he already has his gun strap is right here, and then the bend of the rifle in his coat is right here. And so what I simply did, just a dab of super glue, that'll be easy to take back off again. You match up the stock right here, and then here's his hand and arm come right down here across the end of his rifle. This is really, really nice. It's a great feature, and how it fits together so well is amazing. All right, and then once again, you look at the folds that he has. Here's his canteen, fits right in there. Okay, you see his parka that he has, the anorak. You see the folds, and here's the strap coming across the top right there. All right, you know, all in all, like I say, these will paint up very well. I'm pretty anxious to get started on that vignette that I talked about before. So here in just a minute, we'll follow with some stills. Okay, so here are my two Kharkov figures, all finished up and ready to go. Hopefully in the next few weeks, I'll get some paint on these with my third Alpine guy pointing a direction for the battle. And that will be the end of this segment. Okay, I'd like to thank Dave Youngquist of LastCavalry.com once again for getting these figures to me. And Taesung Harms of Alpine Miniatures, he's you know, knocked another one out of the ballpark. Okay, amazing figures. Really enjoyed putting these together, and they're simply a joy to paint. So, following the stills, I'll give you a picture of what a Kharkov Anorak looks like in color. And like I say, the color variations are quite varied. Okay, in how you can paint these figures up. So with that, we'll go ahead and call this good for this figure review. And until next time, thanks for watching. Subscribe if you get the chance to 1/35th scale figures in review.